Coach DelPorto MAC tournament 2014. Yeah. Eagles are ready to go, it looks like, Coach.
I think so.
We talked at the Ironman. You guys had a historic start. It didn't stop for you right there. You guys kept building off the success. You know, you beat Central Michigan for the first time ever in 23 years. 23, 24 years. You know, you've never won that match yourself as a head coach there.
No.
What did that mean to you, and how much does that build the program up?
Yeah, you know what? That win was so big for our program, especially our guys. You know, our fifth-year seniors have been struggling with that match for a long time, you know. Particularly like Philip Joseph, Nick Wittenberg, Jared Germain. We've been in those matches where, you know, even though they've beaten us maybe 8 matches to 2, 9 matches to 1, it was like, you know, the typical Central Michigan win, 3-2, 2-1 overtime. So we were barely losing those individual matches, but overall losing the duel. But it felt good to go up there and do that, and especially for a guy like Cooter Hibala to pin for us to win. And the craziest part about it is Jason Borelli, check this out. Jason Borelli texted me afterward. He's like, "You're a Borelli killer." And I was like, "Why?" He goes, "You realize that you beat Central the same exact way that you beat Stanford? And it was the exact same score, exact same situation. We had to win the last match by either a tech fall or pin to win the duel. And we did." So it was huge.
Didn't Cooter choose top and pinned him in the third period? You're losing.
Yeah.
4-1, I think.
Yeah, we were losing 3-1.
3-1.
And then we picked top, and that kid was exhausted. Cooter was exhausted. He was power half, and like he was like barely grabbing his fingers to power half, and he just gutted it out and won. That dude's a third placer, one-time third placer at 160 in Michigan. I mean, and to come that far and to put himself in that situation, he won the duel against Old Dominion for us too. So he had his chances. He could have won the Missouri match for us because it came down to heavyweight. It was 15-15 going into heavyweight, and he could have won it for us, but Mellon was just a little too much for him.
The Eagles, you know, I look at it's been a great season, a great story. You know, to cap it off here at the MAC tournament, qualifying-wise, you know, Oklahoma City is obviously where you cap it off, but what's it going to take for Coach Derek DelPorto to be happy in Ypsilanti Sunday night?
I guess first and foremost, I want all my seniors out in Oklahoma City. I just feel like when you're a veteran of the team, when you've put that time in, you deserve a great outcome. So that would be my first thing. My second thing is, if we all wrestle to the potential that we can, I think that best case scenario, you know, we can have 5 guys out at the NCAA, 6 guys maybe. You know, conference tournaments are crazy, Zeb. I mean, anything can happen. Someone slips and falls and lands on their back and you hold them there for a little bit, and all of a sudden you beat somebody who's ranked 5th in the country, and, you know, stuff happens.
I'm looking at, you know, Zurup's, you know, he's had just, it's phenomenal the choice he made. He graduated from Michigan, comes to you guys for his 5th year. His brother's on the team. That's got to be hard for him. It's 6 miles away.
Yeah, no, they're roommates.
It's crazy when I look at that. When I look at that situation, how great has that been for Eastern Michigan to get him?
Yeah, you know what? It's been great because we didn't know how we were going to replace Salzer. And, you know, we were kind of struggling. We knew we had a redshirt freshman that we could throw in there. And then when Brandon showed us interest, and he's known Bulliard forever. And, you know, he was living right down the road. And he's actually got this year and next year left. So even though it's his 5th year, it's his 4th year of wrestling because of medical redshirt. It's been great. And he's one of the nicest dudes walking green earth. And that's why I really like him. And he works his butt off. And he's getting better. Every match he's getting better. You know, you got to remember, he didn't wrestle for 2 years. This is his first year back in 2 years. So he just keeps getting better and better and better. And hopefully he can apex here and then chase it into the Oklahoma City Nationals.
I've been watching Jared Germain's career, you know, and we were talking. It was 2 years ago, I want to say. He's taken Matt McDonough down to his back.
Yeah.
You know, at the NCAA tournament.
Yeah.
A guy like that, I think it's his time to come. We talk about, you know, at the Ironman, you and I talked about punching one through. Yeah. Can he be your guy to punch through?
I think so. I mean, if he wins this tournament, he's seated at the NCAA tournament. You can't take that away from him. If he wins this, he'll be 21-1 with wins over, you know, he'd have to beat maybe Peters, Keener again maybe. You know, I don't know whoever it is, but he's ranked, I don't know, 20th or 18th. So if he wins this, he should be seated at the NCAAs. But our goal is let's get to the finals and have some fun. He's a one match at a time kind of guy, so we never talk to him about next week. We never talk to him about next match. We always just say, hey, do what you do. He's been working so hard for 5 years. I hope that tomorrow and Sunday is his time.
All right, Coach, you got a coach's meeting coming up. You got anything else for me?
No, man. I just hope the best for our guys. They deserve it. And hopefully everybody in the MAC does well next week or 2 weeks at Oklahoma City to prove that this conference is a conference to be reckoned with in the future.